Oh, look at that. Look, you got some food here. No, don't try to bite me. Look, you got some food here. Ooh. Okay, and these are my first time attempted graham crackers, or in this case, cookies. They're still soft, but they should harden a bit. And I made them in the round shape because I like round shape. And yeah, I'm gonna cut this one a little bit. Okay, these ones, separate them. And then I'm going to take a plate and just put them on a plate so that they have a chance to cool down. They're hot, but I can hold them for just a second. So, okay. Okay, and then I have these definitely need to be better split up. The reason I bake these is because I am going to go car camping, do solo car camping for the first time. I've never done any kind of camping, which is weird. But, so I booked a campground, going to a national park, and the only thing that I need to do is prepare for it, mentally and, you know, get some stuff, I guess. So, this is gonna be interesting. I'll record probably some of that. Alright, so the next piece that I'm working on is, let's set cookies aside, and there's one more thing in the oven, and I'm waiting for it. It's a bit more of an experiment, but now I have to bring the oven up to 475 degrees. Because I am baking bread, and this particular recipe is, I'm using it the first time. So here I've got pan de crystal ball or something like that, and this dough has been sitting about an hour and a half. Still needs another half an hour, but I'm kind of excited about this. One thing I need to do, I wipe my hands. I'm going to make this a little bit sticky. Okay. I'm going to make these kind of like openings. Probably needs still another half an hour, so I'm going to let it be, but I will show you what happens after that. It's almost risen to the level I want, so it's gonna be pretty. pretty amazing regardless, so I will let it sit for another half an hour. In the meantime, let me take out this experiment. Ooh, which ended up to be a very hot experiment. Okay, so this experiment was with the remaining dough that I had from those graham crackers, cookies, whatever you call them. And this is so hot. And I put a marshmallow inside. And you can see what happens when marshmallow leaks out. All becomes messy. But I think this will still work. This is just pure sugar. Actually, it's almost crystallized. So I'll let it cool and we'll see what we can do with it. Yeah. The beets. I boil them and then I peel them afterwards like this. It's really easy to remove the peel with just your hand after they're ready and cooked. And some of them are different colors. This was the first time I saw a white and red beet. Not sure what that means, but I might have overboiled them. But amazing. It's amazing when it's not store-bought. So, if you have a chance to shop at your grocery store versus farmer's market, go for the farmer's market. The taste just is so different. The beets at the farmer's market are always very sweet versus those that are sold in the grocery store don't always taste great. But so I got this plus all the ends, I guess the leaves, which I also wash, cut, and then saute. And there was a lot of leaves for $4 at the farmer's market. So, and then what I do with these, with the skins, I just put them in my composting pile. And yeah. All right, we're back to this. And it's looking good. Going to make a couple of indentation. Look at how jiggly this thing is. Amazing. So now, I will just put a little olive of avocado oil on top, and sprinkle a bit of salt. Now it asks, the recipe is for, asks for coarse salt, but you know, looks who's got that. And typically I would put some herbs on top, but because the oven temperature is so hot, they will burn. So this is how we're gonna move forward. All right, let's see what comes out. All right, I think we're ready to take the bread out. And I added a little bit of grated cheddar cheese on top while I was baking. Let's see what it looks like. Definitely time to get out. Very nice, nicely browned. Fantastic. Going to let it cool down, see what looks inside. Well, sadly, it didn't come out exactly how I planned. The back of the bottom really got burnt, which is fine. The top looks okay. Inside came out great, but my oven is definitely, I need a readjustment for the oven. I think it was too close to the bottom, but the good news is that I like things that are a little bit burnt, so this is going to be my dinner.